Hi guys, so Mercedes E-Class convertible. The issue is the wee paddle to release the seat is broken. We've got a new one here off of eBay. That was quite cheap. It was only I think £30 compared to the whole assembly from Mercedes, which was about £400. And I'm going to show you guys how to replace that today. Right, so I've started off with lowering the roof. Put the seat forward. Right, we need to remove, start by removing this panel there. Two torques on the bottom, and then it clips in. Right, so we've removed the screws, and the panel just slides down, and that's it off. Next step is to remove the headrest, and the channel for the ventilated headrests. There's a plug for the headrest, the yellow one, that needs to come off, and then press the headrest and lift it all the way up. Right guys, we had to remove the three pins which go into the motor, and there's two torque screws that hold the actual vent motor in place. So we're going to go ahead. Right, that's the motor out. Two torques, and there are wee clips which clip in into the seat, so you have to pry them and then it slides down just like that. And it's out. Right guys, so the headrest is out. That's the plug that we were unplugging from the back. It just pulls through with a headrest. Also, there's a wee cover, rubber cover, which is just clipped in to the seat there. So a wee pry tool, give it a wee wiggle, and the whole headrest will come out. Now, using a pry tool, we want to pry the piece of seat cover out to expose the bolts which actually hold the handle in place. But before we move on to that, we need to open that wee cover up and disconnect the wiring which actually activates the locks of the seat. So we're going to go ahead and do that. Right, so once we pry it on the side, the wire is exposed. All you need to do is just pull it out and then wiggle it out that hole. Oh, there we go. That's the wire now loose. Right, so there's four wee hooks, 1, 2, 3 and fourth one right there, that hold the actual trim in place, and just there and there, two bolts that hold the actual handle in place. So we're going to go ahead, remove those two torque screws. Now that the two screws are removed, that just pulls out. It's held on by a wee clip. So a wee wiggle and that's the handle out. We're going to move on to fitting the actual paddle on now. I think that'll be a bit trickier. Right. The handle is out. We're going to start by removing the wire which is attached to the actual handle. So we do that by pulling it through and then just lowering it down. The wire is out, quite straightforward. Now we'd get into the tricky bit. There is a wee spring there which needs lifted up so the actual handle is free. Now that's the pin that holds the actual paddle in place. That's quite tricky. I had to, with a blade, right, I had to work the area where the pin, the bolt goes through, enough so I can get a grip on it with those type of grips, just to pull it out. That's it. And the handle is now out. Now to put it back together, reversed order, so we'll put our new handle in just like so. Okay, we're gonna put our pin in to hold the handle in place just like that. Give it a wee wiggle. Now we're gonna push that all the way in, make sure it's secure, and now is the time to put that wee spring back in place. Oh, I actually popped it back in itself. Right, so the wire is in, the handle is in, it springs back, and as you can see, it moves, so it's time to put it back in the car. We'll now fit it back in place and working with the fabric tucked back in. We're going to go ahead, fit the headrest back in, connect it up, and fit the vent motor in as well. Right guys, that's handle now fitted. Works fine. Only tools that I needed for the job was a trim tool, pliers to obviously get the wee pin out that holds the handle in place, a flat screwdriver to retract the wee spring in the actual handle, and a 20 torque on a wee ratchet. All the screws were 20 torquies. Now, I got this off eBay, that's obviously a replacement, don't think it's a genuine med part, but they do them in a chrome finish and in a matte finish, so depending on whatever is fitted on your seat. Mercedes doesn't sell them separately, they only sell the whole assembly at I think close to £300 plus fitting obviously. You can get second hand ones off eBay for £150, but I think £30 it's a steal. It took me an hour to do the job. Quite straightforward. If you found the video helpful, leave a like, subscribe, and if you have any questions, hit the comment below. I will leave the link for the eBay, but you can get the handles in the description below. Like I said, I think it was £35 including postage, which is a steal compared to whatever Matt wanted for the part. So that's it guys, take care.